Hello friends, in this video we are going to talk about one of the method of video compression, that is nothing but MPEG-2. In this video we are going to discuss about the various standards provided by MPEG-2 and various frames which are present in the standard MPEG-2. So let's begin with the topic. Video compression is nothing but a method which is used to convert a video into a lower file size, so that during a transmission, the video uses a less bandwidth for the transmission, and during storage, the video can be stored on the less space. So because of this, effective utilization of bandwidth and effective utilization of available space takes place. So video compression method is basically divided into three different types, or we can say the techniques of video compression having three different techniques. The first one is H.246, the second one is MPEG-2, and the fourth next one is MPEG-4. Now in this topic we are specifically going to talk about the video compression MPEG-2. So let's start with this. So let's first understand what do you mean by a letter that is MPEG and 2. Basically the MPEG is nothing but Moving Picture Expert Group. So basically MPEG is a method for video compression which involves compression of digital images and sound as well as synchronization of the two. That means we can perform the synchronization between the video sound and video image. At the same time we can perform a compression of the video file so that the file size it gets reduced and it becomes very much easier for the transmission of the signal. Now there are various different methods of MPEG comes into the picture. So let's start with the principle. In principle, a motion picture is basically a rapid flow of set of frames, and each frame is nothing but an image. So in other words, we can also say that a frame is a spatial combination of pixel, and a video is a temporal combination of frames that are sent one after another. So this is what about the basic principle behind the technique that is MPEG-2. Now let's find out, or let's write down the various available MPEG standards. So the first one is MPEG-1. It provides intermediate data rate. Then the next one is, it is for moderate or high data rate and provides the data rate of 10 Mbps. Now the next one is MPEG-3, which is basically used for compression of the video in case of high definition TV. And last one is MPEG-4, which is provides very slow data rate, which is having a range of 64 kbps. So there are four different standards, MPEG-1, 2, 3, and 4. Out of that, MPEG-2 is provides data rate of highest data rate, which is of 10 mbps, and MPEG-4 provides slow data rates, that is 64 kbps. Now we are going to talk about the MPEG-2. So let's first understand the various characteristics of the MPEG-2. So basically MPEG-2 is considered as an extension of MPEG-1, and it is published in 1995, and it is considered as an ISO IEC 13818 standard. Now let's see what are the various characteristics provided by MPEG-2 standard. So it defines a coding method to compress progressively scanned video as well as interlaced scanned video. Then the second characteristic is it is used for broadcasting format which are nothing but the standard definition TV, that is SDTV, and the second one is the high definition TV, that is HDTV. It supports coding bitrate of 3 to 15 Mbps for STD and 15 to 20 Mbps for high definition TVs. Now let's see how MPEG-2 standard provides different kinds of frame. So basically the MPEG-2 compression provides three different kinds of frames for a raw frame, and they are nothing but first one is iframe, which stands for intra-coded frame. Second is stands for P frame, which is nothing but predictive coded frame, and third one is nothing but the B frame, which is nothing but bidirectional predictive coded frame. So these three are the frames which are provided by MPEG-2 standard when it compresses a raw frame. Now let's look at the various techniques that can be used by MPEG-2 for compression. So basically the compression is based on two methods, and these are First one is spital redundancy, and second is nothing but time-based redundancy. Now, in the next topic, we are going to start with the detailed description of each frame, that is I, P and B frame. So let's start. So here, first of all, before going to understand the various frames provided by the MPEG-2 standard, first we will have the understanding of the frames which are coming into the group. So the compressed frame, that is IPB frames, are organized in a sequence of group and called as group of picture, that is nothing but GOP. So the figure shows GOP which consists of I, B and P frame. So this forms one GOP and 5, 6, 7 forms other GOP. So now let's start with the description of I frame. So basically, I frame stands for intracloudate frame, and this frame is considered as an independent of any other frames. Now, in case of I frame, the I frame must appear at the regular interval. The I frame must be present at regular interval, and it is used for holding some sudden change in the frame which are not provided by the previous or following frame. Now, so when the video is broadcasted, it is possible that the user can tune to the video at any moment of time. So if only one iframe is present, then the user which tune after a certain period of time may not able to receive a complete picture, and therefore it is very much important that the iframe must be appear after a certain interval. So there are a number of iframe present into the picture. Now iframe is considered as an independent frame and it is do not related to any other frame. Now let's see what are the characteristics that are provided by iframe. So it compresses directly from form of raw frame, that is uncompressed frame, we can say. The compression is based on the spital redundancy in the current raw frame only and inability of the human eye to detect certain changes in the image. Now the iframe is basically acts as a reference plane and can be used to predict the P frame immediately following it. So with the help of I frame, we can be able to produce P as well as B frame. In the next topic, that things we are going to discuss. Now let's see how the I frame look. So this is basically a format of I frame which is obtained from uncompressed frame, as we have discussed earlier. That is, it is compression. It is basically a directly compressed frame for a raw frame. Therefore, it consists of only raw frame which is in uncompressed form. So this is how basically the I frame looks like. Now the next frame that we are going to discuss is nothing but P frame, that is predictive crowded frame. So basically the P frame is obtained from a previous iframe or preceding frame. The P frame do not contain more information as compared to other frames. The P frame can be formed either by using the preceding frame or by using the iframe. Now let's have a look of the various characteristics provided by P frame. So compression is based on the spital redundancy, as well as it is also based on the time based redundancy. The P frame can be predicted by referring iframe, because we use iframe as a reference frame for formation of P and B frame, or it can be also be formatted, or it can also be predicted by using a P frame immediately preceding it. P frame is also a reference frame for formation of the next P frame. So now P frame provides better compression than iframe, as it uses data of previous iframe and P frame. So because of this, it is possible to provide a more information or better compression as compared to other frame, but the information contained in the P frame is very much less as compared to the information present in other frames. Now let's have a look of the diagram of formation of P frame. So the first is nothing but the formation of P frame by using preceding I frame. So previous I frame is used for the formation of next P frame. And second, the reference is used as a P frame only. Therefore, both the frame, that is previous and next frame, are used as a P frame. So by using these two methods, we can produce a P frame. Now let's move on to the next type of frame, that is nothing but B frame. So B frame is basically stands for bidirectional phase frame, as its name indicates. It is formed by using either preceding as well as following P frame, or it is formed by using preceding as well as following I frame. So now let's have a look of the various characteristics. The compression is similar to P frame, except that B frame compression is done by referring previous as well as following I frame or P frame, as we discussed earlier, only that it uses both the frames. Either it uses preceding and following I frame, or it uses preceding or following I or P frame, because mostly I is independent frame, so it is used as a reference frame for formation of P and B frame. Now B frame required frame sequence must be transmitted or stored out of order so that the future frame is available for the reference. And now it causes basically some delay throughout the system. Now B frame provides better compression as compared to P and I frame, as it uses data of previous as well as preceding P or I frame. Now it requires memory buffers because it uses data which was previous and preceding I and P frame. Therefore it requires a memory buffer of double size to store the data of two frames, because we are using preceding and following frame. So as it forms a two frame, so for storing that data, we require double size buffer in case of B frame. Now let's look how the formation of B frame takes place. So here basically a B frame is formed, which consists of previous I frame and preceding or future or following P frame. So with the help of I and P frame, we can form a B frame. As it stores data of two frame, it requires a buffer of two double size. So it is not considered as a reference frame because it uses it is get formed by using two frames only. So it is not considered as a reference. There is no defined limit of the number of consecutive B frame within a group of picture. N number of frames can be get created. There is no limit for the formation of B frame, and they can be formed in a continuous way also. Most application uses two consecutive B frames as the ideal trade-off between the compression efficiency and voltage quality. So on the basis of the parameter, that is the compression efficiency and video quality, most of the pictures or most of the frame uses two B frame. So this is what about the MPEG frames, which consist of I, P and B frame. And this is what about the video compression technique MPEG 2. So I hope you understand this topic. So let's summarize it once again. So MPEG 2 is basically stands for Motion Picture Expert System or Motion Picture Expert Group, which is having several standards, which include 1, 2, 3 and 4. 1 is used to provide intermediate data rate. 2 is used to provide higher data rate. 3 is used for SDT and high definition TVs, and 4 is used for providing the low data rate, which is having a range of 64 kbps. Then we go through the various standards or various frames provided by MPEG standard, and there are three different frames: I, P and B frame. Then we also discuss about the methods of compression used by MPEG 2 standards, and there are two methods. First one is the spital and second one is the time delay method. Then we discussed about the frames provided by MPEG. First one is I, which is independent frame, are used as a reference frame. Second one is the P frame, which holds the information from preceding I frame or preceding P frame. That means it can be formed by using I as well as P frame, and it is also used as a reference frame for B frame. Then the next is nothing but B frame, which is bidirectional predicted coded frame, which uses both following as well as preceding frame, and therefore it requires buffer, which is having a double size for storing the content of two frame. So this is what about the MPEG 2 standard. So I hope you understand this topic. So thank you very much for watching this video. Stay tuned to Ikeda. Subscribe Ikeda. Thank you.